they are facade. All right, I want you to give a big round of applause to Mrs. Sager.
So excited to be back at Zebra Zone. And I have something very, very special for you today. And it's all because you worked so hard on your reading challenge. Do you remember before Christmas, we had these hanging up in the cafeteria?
Yes!
And there was one for each grade. And as you learned more sight words in kindergarten, your superhero moved down the wall. And in first grade, as you read more books, your superhero would move. And second graders, they are reading counts points. And I'll tell you what, you guys did a fantastic job. I'm going to tell you just how well you did. Kindergartners, they set a goal. And when you set a goal, that means you're going to work hard to try to accomplish that and get it finished. They said they would learn 2,100 sight words. That's a lot. Do you know how many kindergartners learned 2,428 words? Let's give them a big hand. That is an awesome job. Boys and girls, remember, when you learn sight words, then you can learn how to read books, and that's so exciting. First graders thought they could read 1,500 books. That's a pretty big goal. First graders read 1,871 books. Good for you. And now, for second graders, ready for second grade? Thank you. Second graders said that they could earn 2,100 reading counts points. And they earned 3,160. You are awesome. Boys and girls, I am so proud of you for working so hard. And we promised you a reward if you would meet your goals, and so you get your reward. It's been a while, so you may not remember what it is. We said Mr. Snyder would dress up as a superhero. Guess what? And all of you said you wanted him to be Captain America. He's a really good sport. Are you ready? Are you sure you're ready? Okay. Captain Underpants. Remember, reading gives you superpowers.
Challenge. Continue to read. You're doing a great job. Have a great afternoon.
Thank you. We're going to start a new challenge soon. We're going to have a whoop it up for books, and maybe we can get Mr. Snyder to do the hula hoop for us next week.
Yeah.
we learn a new big idea. And a big idea, remember, is just something that grows inside us so we can help change the world around us. And this month, we are learning about...
Yes, we learn lots of things. We learn lots of things, and I've really been learning things. Okay. I'm controlling my temper. I'm learning.
That is really great. This is my co-host, Mrs. Smith.
Howdy, folks.
You look like you've kind of been in a...
Oh, I overslept. See, I accidentally unplugged my alarm clock because I was trying to get the cat out from behind the bed.
You don't have a cat. Wait a minute. You didn't get angry?
No, not at the cat or anything because, you know, the cat was just trying to get away and find a safe place to be from the Rottweiler that I rescued. Accidentally.
Accidentally?
Yeah, it's kind of a long story. I've been taking in stray pets and plants. It has something to do with I came in one day and left the door open when I was bringing in groceries, but, you know, you don't need to know any of that. What you just need to know is I am going to keep my New Year's resolution.
A New Year's resolution?
Yep.
I didn't know you made a New Year's resolution.
I didn't really tell anybody, just in case, you know, I couldn't keep it.
That's probably a good idea. But since you're here now, would you like to go ahead and do our big idea definition?
Can I have a minute? See, earlier today there was a traffic jam. Yes, a traffic jam. A traffic jam on Main Street because some nut thought that he could do a U-turn in an RV on Main Street. Okay.
Why don't you just take a little break, okay? And boys and girls, why don't you start a drum roll on your legs for me? Let's count it down. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1. Knowledge. Discovering something new so you can be better at whatever you do. That's right. Knowledge means discovering something new so you can be better at whatever you do.
And I have learned that sometimes I get a little excited and things push me to being angry. I'm okay, and I'm learning better and new things.
I am so proud of you. You're learning something new, and I'm also proud that you're here today after that crazy morning you had. I bet you didn't even have any caffeine or any sugar.
No.
Could somebody bring Mrs. Smith a cup of coffee and maybe a donut?
Yes, that is so nice of you. Thank you. That will make me feel so much better.
Oh, I'm so glad.
Especially because I didn't get a good... Aw, thank you. You're so nice. When I was leaving this morning, I didn't get a really good look at my couch, but it looked not so good. I think that the Rottweiler went and tore it up. There's like stuffing everywhere.
You know, Mrs. Smith, I really am very proud of you. Now, it's not easy to learn something new, especially learning to control your temper. And boys and girls, you know, whenever you learn to control your temper, it makes you better at everything else that you do. So, Mrs. Smith, if there's anything that I can do to help you with this, you just let me know.
Oh, thanks. That's so nice of you, Mrs. Amy. Sure. But I think I've got it. It's been almost a week, but I've kept it under control, even when that stray cat came out of me and got on my face at 3 a.m. and started scratching me. And when my friend, posted those not so flattering pictures of me on Facegram. That's all right.
Mrs. Smith.
I know.
You sat on the...
Yes. No. I'm good. It's just that these pants are the only ones that the Rottweiler has not eaten.
Together. I'm sure she'll be right back soon. So let's just
peanut butter. Why did you ask?
Well, because you're not wearing any pants.
You know what? Never mind. Let's just go on. Let's ask her how her New Year's resolution is coming. Say, how's your New Year's resolution coming?
Because she's working so hard to learn something new, and that's not easy. Her knowledge is growing. But maybe I better go check on her while you check out this video.
Junction, how's that?
one last chance to show off your education to your children. You remember, I'm sure, our friend who was just a bill. He was only a bill and he was waiting there on Capitol Hill. He hoped and he prayed that one day he would become something else. What did the bill hope to become?
He wanted to become a wall.
That's
basement, and Rita's all, I'm gonna turn it in to an art studio. And her dad's like, I can't drive a nail without pounding my gong. Jump in your Havana! So, while her dad's away at work, Rita starts thinking about just how awesome her art studio is gonna be. She says, I'm gonna build a 10-foot-long workbench and paint every single wall a different color, like cobalt and fuchsia and lavender. And she says, I'm gonna build an amazing snack bar for when I get hungry and build a special nook just for naps. Totally doable. So Rita starts hauling all the things she thinks she'll need down to the basement, like boards and nails and a power drill and 56 cans of paint and shag carpeting. And she's totally finished with the whole art studio by the time her dad gets home from work. And her dad's like, Uncle Jerry can help you out. And Uncle Jerry's totally cool with helping her learn. He's like, start here. And Rita says, seriously? But she reads, and she learns how to use a hammer.
I just feel, huh?
And how to use a power drill and work out a design. And finally, Uncle Jerry steps back and says, you got this, kiddo. And then they get ready to build the whole art studio together. And Rita's dad is super impressed. Rita tells him, hey, Dad, maybe I can teach you a thing or two. And then they get started for real. And this time, Rita knows exactly what to do. Watch this. So kids, I hope this helps you remember that knowledge is learning something new so you can be better at whatever you do. I gotta get better at keeping these packs on. See you guys next time.
Welcome to the game. Are you greater than a second grader? With us today, we have our very own, the one and only, Mrs. Reinhold. Wow, Mrs. Reinhold, we are so thrilled you could join us today. Why don't you go ahead and tell the audience a little bit about yourself?
Well, Mrs. Schrock, just like you said, My name is Mrs. Reinhold, and I'm from Butter Chug, Wyoming. I love puppies and freshly washed socks and leather goods, too. On the weekends, I enjoy practicing my piccolo and also sketching little menu items like french fries
Mrs. Reinhold. Wow, you sure are fascinating. Let's go ahead and move on to Are You Greater Than a Second Grader? Now for those of you who have never seen the show before, this is how it goes. Our contestant, Mrs. Reinhold, will be asked three questions. Today, the questions will be about reading, history, and math. Mrs. Reinhold gets to decide, is she going to answer the questions on her own, or will she ask one of our three second graders? We have three selected from Mrs. Gongor's class, Riley, Emma, and Leandro. They're gonna make their way out here. And go ahead and have a seat in one of these three chairs. Perfect. There's Riley, Leandro, and Emma. All right, let the battle of the brains begin. Question number one.
Actually, Mrs. Schrock, I won't be needing any help from the second grade panel. I don't know if you've noticed, but some people around here find me highly ineffectual.
You mean intellectual?
That's what I said.
Right, okay. Well, Mrs. Reinhold, you know, they've walked all the way up here. Why don't we just let them stay, like, you know, just in case?
Sure, whatever. Just so long as I do not need any help. I got this thing in the bag.
Okay, well, anyway, let's go ahead and begin. Question number one. Mrs. Reinhold,
I'm ready.
When did the U.S.
The U.S.? I live in the U.S. I love, love, love the U.S. Did you know Hawaii is in the U.S.? Hawaii is beautiful. It has beaches, and it's warm, and
yes.
It's an island.
Yeah, could I please get through one question before you interrupt me?
Oh, sure.
Like I was saying, question number one. When did the U.S. Civil War end?
Are you joking? This one is so easy. The Civil War ended when it ended, before the new one started, and after the other one got over.
No, that's not really the answer we were looking for. Actually, we're looking for the year that it ended. Would you like to see what one of our second graders has written down?
I'm telling you, I really don't need any help. I can rely on my own knowledge to figure this stuff out. But if it makes the audience feel better, I'll allow the panel to express their opinion.
Well, that's very kind of you. Emma, would you please show us what's on your card? Let's read it together. 1865.
No, I'm confident. I'll go with my answer.
All right, let's see the judges say. Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Reinhold. The correct answer was, like Emma said, 1865. Maybe you'll have better luck with question number two. Let's check it out. Question number two. When an author writes a story, they usually have a purpose. What is one of the reasons an author would write a story?
Okay. I've got this one. We all know there's one reason why an author would write a story. Well, wait, maybe there's two. An author writes a story so that he can get a really good grade on his report card, but he also might write a story so he can make a lot of money selling his book.
That's a very interesting take on the question, but why don't we just go ahead and take a look at what Riley's written down. Riley, show us your answer. To persuade, inform, or entertain. Hi! What do you think, Mrs. Reinhold?
I wasn't finished yet. I knew that's what it was. Who doesn't know what the author's purpose is? So yeah, that second grader, she like read my mind or something.
What do you think, guys? You agree with Riley? Today. Okay. Question number three.
Yes.
What 3D shape has 6 faces and 8 vertices?
I know that one. But just in case, let's see what the third second grader thinks. Just to let him say something.
You know, I think that's a good idea. Leandro, let's see what you have written down. A cube.
Oh, right. That's just what I was thinking. What that says, final answer.
That is correct. You've all done such a great job. Give them a big round of applause. Our 3 second graders, come on up. I have a prize for you. Here's that Snickers. Yep, you can take them right on out and go back to your seats. Thanks, friends.
Well, here's the thing. I know this might come as a shock to you, but I didn't know. And it's been a long time since I've been in second grade. I thought I could figure it out on my own, but I couldn't.
You know what? You bring up a really good point. Sometimes we ask questions and we don't know the answers to them, and that's okay, because guess what? School is a great place to learn. So, why don't you just come to school every day thinking, I'm gonna learn one new thing. Like maybe you'll learn to get a little bit better in math and you'll be doing things you never know you could do before.
That sounds kind of lame.
Well, I disagree, because when you gain knowledge, you're discovering new things and you're learning, and hey, if you read more, maybe you'll be watching TV one day and you'll understand a joke that they made. Or you'll be listening to your favorite song and all of a sudden, the lyrics will make sense.
Well, that is good news then. Maybe it's not so lame at all.
No.
And I know my ABCs.
Well, yes, learning your ABCs. You can learn writing and reading.
And burping. 26 of them. All 26 I can burp on. You want to hear?
No.
But when we started back after the break, Ms. Henderson said it was going to get a lot harder. Everybody else seemed to be following along, but I did again. I wanted to say, can we please slow down? But I didn't want to look stupid. No one else was asking questions, so I sat there and sat there and sat there. Finally, I was so confused, I didn't even care anymore. I raised my hand. I asked her to please explain what the first step meant. I guess I thought people might laugh. They didn't. Ms. Henderson asked if anyone else had the same question. Almost everybody raised their hand. I learned something today. I learned what my dad always told me was true. The only dumb question is the one you don't ask. Love, heart.
Because you can learn, and guess what? a knowledge bookmark. I want you to color that knowledge bookmark, and I want you to put it in one of the books that you are reading, because I want it to be a reminder to you that the more we